हेलो फ्रेंड्स नसु लारेंस प्रसन्न नानु एर सविद आरनेसविंद स्पोकन इंग्लिश तरगति नडस्ता एंटू वर्ष हिंदे डीवीडी नानु वीडियो शूट माडिट्टिद्दे आनंतर नानु साध्य आगलिल्ल बोर्ड टीचिंग समेत बोर्ड टीचिंग मत्ते अदक्के संबंधपट्टंत आक्टिविटीस नन्न फैमिली नन्न गुरुगळ फैमिली मत्ते स्नेहितर फैमिली बळसि नानु आक्टिविटीस अवत्र माडिसिदेनि अंद्रे कलियोदक्के सुलभवागलि अंत आ डीवीडी नानीग यूट्यूब नल्लि अपलोड माड्ता इद्दीनि केवल 12 दिनगळल्लि इंग्लिश कलि अंत यूट्यूब नल्लि अपलोड माड्ता इद्दीनि ನಿಮಗೆ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಏನೋ ಅರ್ಧಂಬರ್ಧ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಗ್ರಾಮರ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂಥ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಹಾಗೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂಥ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ಗಳು ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಕಲಿಯೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸುಲಭ ಆಗಲಿ ಅಂತ ಇದನ್ನು ನಾನು ತಯಾರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕುಟುಂಬ ಕೂತು ಕಲೀಲಿ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಕೇಳೋವಂಥದ್ದು ಇದನ್ನು ನಾನು ಒಂದೊಂದಾಗಿ ಅಪ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀನಿ ನೀವು ನನಗೆ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ನೀವು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಹಾಗೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆದ್ರೆ ಈ ಲೈಕ್ ಬಟನ್ ನಾ ಒತ್ತಿ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡಿಸ್ಲೈಕ್ ಬಟನ್ ನಾ ಒತ್ತಿ ಹಾಗೆ ಬೆಲ್ ಐಕಾನ್ ನಾ ಹಾಕಿ ಯಾಕೆ ನಾನು ಈ 12 ಸ ಆದ ನಂತರ ಕೂಡ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂತ ನನ್ನ ಇತ್ತೀಚಿನ ಅನುಭವಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಲಭವಾದ ಕಲಿಯ ಮಾರ್ಗಗಳನ್ನ ನಾನು ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕ್ತಾ ಅಪ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀನಿ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನೀವು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗದ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳಿ ಹಾಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಗೆಲ್ಲ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳಿ ಯಾಕೆ ನೀವು ಕೊಡುವಂಥದ್ದು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ತುಂಬ ಹಣ ಖರ್ಚು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ನನಗೆ ವಾಪಸ್ ಕೊಡುವಂಥದ್ದು ನೀವು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರ ಮೂಲಕ ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಕಲಿತು ನೀವು ಟೀಚ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ಕಲಿಯೋದ್ರ ಮೂಲಕ ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಕಲಿಕೆಗೆ ಈ ಥರ ಇದ್ರೆ ಸುಲಭ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಆ ಥರ ಇದ್ರೆ ಸುಲಭ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಮಾಡಿರೋಂಥದ್ದು ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಭಾಷೆಯಲ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಕನ್ನಡದ ಮೂಲಕ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ಹೇಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಕನ್ನಡ ಮಾತೃಭಾಷೆ ನಾವು ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದು ಬೇರೆ ಭಾಷೆಯಿಂದಲ್ಲ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲೇ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಕಲಿತು ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಮೂಲಕನೇ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಕಲಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊಂದಲ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು ಆದರೂ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಏನು ಕಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ನನಗೆ ಹಾಕಿ ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಆ ಡಿವಿಡಿಗಳ 12 ದಿವಸಕ್ಕೆ ಚಿಕ್ಕದು ಮಾಡಿ 12 ದಿವಸ ಅಪ್ಲೋಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಸೊ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮಿಂದ ಬಯಸಿದ್ದದ್ದು ನೀವು ನನಗೆ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗಿ ನನ್ನ ಚಾನಲ್ಗೆ ಹಾಗೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನು ಅನಿಸುತ್ತೆ ಆ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಂಗೆ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸೊ ಈಗ ನೋಡೋಣಂತೆ ಮೊದಲ ದಿನದ ಪಾಠಗಳನ್ನ
Hello friends, do you speak English? Think and say. I say that you speak English. I am not joking. I am saying truth. For example,
book, TV, pant, pen, switch on, switch off, start, speed. Ring, mobile, recharge, stop, fast, start.
Like this, if we go on speaking, it takes one day. Whatever we speak daily in our mother tongue, we use many English words greater than our mother tongue words. And also, we make sentences also in English. For example,
ಡೋರ್ ಓಪನ್ ಮಾಡು ಡೋರ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಮಾಡು ಬೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡು ಬೈಕ್ನ ಸ್ಪೀಡಾಗಿ ಓಡಿಸ್ಬೇಡ ಟಿವಿ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡು ಟಿವಿ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡು ಸೌಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡು ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ರಿಂಗ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಲೇಟ್ ಆಯಿತು
ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಹೋಯಿತು ಸಿ How many English words are there? Only to complete the sentences, we are using Kannada words. Now, do you agree that you are speaking English? About 80% English words are being used, but we don't know to make sentence, that's all. What is sentence? A group of words which gives full meaning is called sentence. Mainly, you must learn is sentence making. How to make sentences will be taught slowly. Now, an example for a sentence.
I was born in 1977.
It is a sentence having many words. The words whatever we have used to make sentence, all those words are divided into parts. In English, that parts are called parts of speech.
Parts andre bhagagalu, of andre na, speech andre matu. Matina bhagagalu.
These are those parts. The first one is
noun,
means naming word, the word which tells the name. The second one is pronoun, means it is used instead of name. The third one is adjective. They give more information about noun or pronoun. The fourth one is verb, means it shows an action, action word. The fifth one is adverb. It gives more information about action, where, when and how. The sixth one is preposition. It is a position showing word. The seventh one is conjunction, means connecting words. The eighth is interjection. They are used to express sudden feelings. One more is there, that is articles. They are a, an, the. These all will be taught deeply in the next classes. You must learn all these words because to make sentences and to speak in English, they are required very much. In parts of speech, the first is
noun.
Noun means naming word. They indicate names. It may be name of anything. It may be name of persons. It may be name of thing. Name of place. For example,
Lawrence, Bengaluru, mobile, pen, bike.
Like this. In nouns, there are kinds. In that, first one is
proper noun.
It refers name of person, name of place and name of things with brand name. Proper noun indicates this much.
Name of person.
Gandhiji, Swami Vivekananda.
Name of places.
New York, Delhi.
Name of things with brand name.
Parker pen, Innova car, Pulsar bike, Samsung mobile.
Regarding proper noun, you also say your own examples and also write them in your notebook. For that, pause your TV. In noun, the second is common noun. It refers commonly. One name indicates its species or class.
Pen.
It may be any pen.
Bike.
It may be any bike. If a brand name is added, it will become proper noun.
Second one is common noun.
Mobile. Pen. Man. Bike. city.
Say your own examples for common noun and write them in your notebook. For that, pause your TV. In noun, the third one is
collective noun.
Collect means bring together or gather together. Things or something which are in group or which are together, to name them, words are used, that is common noun. For example, a bunch of banana, heap of sand, heap of stones.
Third one is collective noun.
A bunch of grapes, a bundle of papers, a bundle of leaves, a bunch of banana.
You must have seen many things which are in group around you. Say them and write them as example for collective noun. For that, pause your TV. In noun, the fourth one is
abstract noun.
Means they are words to express our sudden feelings. It belongs to mind. They do not have physical structure. We can express them.
Fourth one is abstract noun.
Cry. Sadness.
When we are talking about a person, place or some other thing, at the beginning we say name of them. If we talk about the same person or same thing, instead of name we use other words second time onwards. For example, he, she, that, it. These are called pronoun, means they are used instead of name. For example,
Gandhi was born in Porabandaru. Here, first time you are talking about a person, so I have used your name. If you want to talk about the same person, second time onwards, we have to use your pronoun instead of name. Here, he is your pronoun. Instead of Gandhi, I have used your he. Second time onwards, we have to use your pronouns only. For male, we have to use here he. For female, we have to use here she for single person.
While showing our hand towards a person, we can use pronoun words. For example, he, she. While showing our hands towards one thing, we have to use here pronoun it. If there are things more than one, means many things, then we have to use here pronoun they. In pronoun, there are five kinds. The first one is
subject pronoun.
These subject pronouns are used always at the beginning of the sentence and they come always before the verb. Subject means when we talk about a person, the person who does the action, it will become subject word, and whatever we talk about, even it doesn't do any action, that is also subject. Subject pronouns are
I, you, we, they, he, she, it. They are used at the beginning of the sentence. See here, this is your subject pronoun, this is your subject pronoun, and this is your subject pronoun. This is one technique. One more technique. Subject words come always before the verb. See here, teach is your verb and watch is your verb, bathe is your verb. Subject words are here always before the verb.
I.
You.
We.
They.
They.
They. He.
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 She.
She.
It.
It.
Write all the subject pronouns in your notebook. Subject words are given in book and also pronunciation is given in CD. Learn now itself and go further. In pronouns, second one is
object pronoun.
Object means on which the action is performed will become object word. It may be person or anything. Usually, object words are used always after the verb. In other language, this object word comes always before the verb. But in English, object word comes always after the verb.
Object pronouns are me, you, us, them, him, her, it. Object pronouns are used always after the verb. Love is a verb. I love her. And here she is a verb. Me is a object word. Any sentence it may be. Object words are used always after the verb. Keep it in your mind.
Write all the object words in your notebook. Learn object pronouns and meanings of them looking into book or listening to CD now itself. In pronoun, the third is reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronouns are used when a person does the action and that action is performed on the same person, then reflexive pronouns are used. For example, I beat myself. I only did the action and done on me. In these situations are used reflexive pronouns. Reflexive pronouns usually are used after verb.
Reflexive pronouns are myself, yourself, ourselves, themselves, himself, herself, itself, yourselves. Here self is used, self for one person and selves for more than one person, for two person, three person, four person, more than one person. Reflexive pronouns are used usually after the verb. I learnt myself. Learnt is a verb. Myself is a reflexive pronoun. It is used after the verb. One more example. He fell himself. Fell is a verb. Himself is a reflexive pronoun. Here also reflexive pronoun is used after the verb.
Write all the reflexive pronouns now itself in your notebook. Looking into the book, learn spellings and pronunciation. Learn now itself. For that, pause your TV. In pronoun, the fourth is possessive pronoun. Possess means become owner. Possession means property. If there is a property, there must be an owner, right? That ownership pronouns are possessive pronouns. For example, this mobile mine.
This mobile is mine. Possessive pronouns are mine, yours, ours, theirs, his, hers. And there is no possessive pronoun for it.
Mine means I am the owner. It is pronoun, but my is possessive adjective. Learn now.
Possessive adjectives are my, your, our, their, his, her, its.
When name comes to show ownership after the name, apostrophe S should be added. Apostrophe means a comma which is upset. It is a sign to put after or before any letter. When there is a common noun, means general word. For example, boy, girl, with these words, of boy, to say with singular noun, after boy, apostrophe S should be written. Then it will become boys. Boys means of one boy. Now, boys means more than one, many. Same pronunciation. To say of boys, apostrophe should be put after S letter. Then it will become of boys. All the possessive pronouns and all the possessive adjectives should be written in notebook now itself. Learn pronunciation and spellings of the words looking in the book. For that, pause your TV now. In pronoun, the fifth is
general pronoun.
General means usual. She means girl or woman. She should be used only for female, means girl or woman. He means boy or man. This should be used for male, boy or man. But
somebody
means an unknown person. That can be used for girl or for boy. All means whole. It can be used only for boys or only for girls or for boys and girls. Like these pronouns are called general pronouns. They are
somebody, nobody, all, both, anybody, everything, something, nothing, few, and some more words are there. General pronouns can be used as subject word also and object word also. For example, general pronoun is used at the beginning of the sentence and it is used before the verb. So here it is subject word. Here general pronoun is used as object word because it is used after the verb. When pronoun or name used at the beginning of the sentence, they will become subject word. And when name, noun or pronouns are used after the verb, they are used always as object words.
General pronouns can be used as subject word and also object word. If it is used before verb and at the beginning of the sentence, it will become subject. If it is used after verb, then it will become object word. All these pronouns are divided again into three persons. The first
person
means I or we. Second is second person means you or yours. Third is third person means he, she, it and they. Again,
first person singular I. Plural, we, more than one, two, three, four, like. Second person singular, you, and plural also, you for more than one person, two, three, four persons. Third person singular, he, she, it. Plural form, they means for more than one person.
Friends, if you go on watching, you can understand, but you cannot get practice. Words of all these pronouns are given in book and also in CD. Learn the pronunciation of all those words. These are used so much while talking. More general pronouns words are given in book. Learn all the pronouns today itself. Dear students, to speak English, you must know many words. So learn many words and also read English books daily. Think in English and speak English daily, whether it is right or wrong.
Silver, clay.
Regarding material nouns, you also say some examples. Write all of them in your notebook. For that, pause your TV. Regarding nouns, many words are given in book. Pronunciation of that words are given in CD. If you want to learn more English, you must learn many words. So, learn many words, pronunciation and meaning. In parts of speech, the third is adjective. Adjectives give more information about subject word. Speciality, they say about persons, places, animals, birds and other things. And some say generally. Some adjectives tell us about quality of people, like good, bad, beautiful, tall person, generous, like this.
Kind person, fat man, short person, tall person, cruel man, beautiful girl.
For quality of person, you also say some examples and write them in your notebook. For that, pause your TV. Some adjectives tell us about quality of things.
Rotten tomato, fresh tomato, costly sari, sharp knife.
For quality of things, you say your own examples and write them in your notebook. For that, pause your TV. Some adjectives tell us about mood of people.
Dull, sad, silent.
For mood of people or state of mind of people, you also say your own examples. For that, pause your TV. Some adjectives tell us about nature of place.
Cold place, hilly region, ghat section, dirty place, crowded city.
Say some examples for nature of places and write them in your notebook. For that, pause your TV. Some adjective words tell us about color of something.
White car, black bike, green file, white sari, blue pant.
Say some examples for adjective of color of something and write them in your notebook. Totally, adjective words give more information about subject words. Friends, many adjective words are given in this part and also in the next part. Learn all of them using book and CD and try to speak English daily. Thank you. to keep in your memory for a long time the explanation I give you and whatever I write on the board, write them in your notebook. In parts of speech, the fourth is verb. Verb means action word, means it says about work or activities. In verbs, there are two kinds. The first is regular verb. The second is irregular verb. But in verbs, there are mainly three forms. The first is present verb. It is first form of verb. The second is past verb. The third is
past participle verb.
Now, let us learn about regular verb. What is regular? Continuously, without missing. See here, in present verb, ask is here. And also, it is continued in past verb also. See here.
Ask, ask.
And it is continued in past participle verb also. See here, ask, ask. And one more example, present verb, love is there. Love word is also continued in past verb. And it is also continued in past participle verb, L-O-V-E. That's why it is called regular verb. But present verb, to become past verb and past participle verb, to few verbs, we have to add here ED letters. For some other verbs, D letters should be added. See here, with ask, ED letters are added. With love, only D letter is added. It is now past verb. In the same way, here also, ask has taken ED letters. Love has taken D letter. Like this, they have become past participle verbs. That's why they are called weak verb. Weak verb. Here you may get confusion. Where to add ED letters and where to add D letter. See here, present verb. When it ends with E letter, D letter should be added there. And when the present verb ends with by any other letters, ED letter should be added. See here, it is ended with K letters, so ED letters are added here. By adding ED letters to present verb, they will become past form and past participle form. Regular verbs or weak verbs are many in numbers. They are given in the book. Verbs are grouped into many. For example, verbs belong to human. Verbs used at kitchen. Verbs used at house. Verbs used in education. Verbs belong to animals. Like this, they are grouped and given in book. You must learn pronunciation and meanings of that verbs. Now, write regular verb or weak verbs as examples in your notebook, which is written on the board. Now, learn about irregular verb. See here, the form of present verb doesn't come in past form and also not in past participle form. For example, do form is here. Here it is did word and here it has become done. One more example, here present verb write is there. It is not continued same, it is changed into wrote. Past participle verb is changed into written. Like these verbs are called irregular verb. Irregular verbs from present verb to past verb and to become past participle verb, they do not take any help of any letters. That's why they are also called by another name, strong verb. Strong verbs or irregular verbs are lesser than regular verbs. They are also given in each part. Dear students, now pause your TV and write them in your notebook. One more kind of verbs are there. There is no any kind of change. spellings and pronunciations which are in present verb are also continued in past verb and also continued in past participle verb. Like these verbs are also strong verbs because without taking any help of any letters, they become past and past participle form. Write all of them in your notebook. For that, pause your TV. Present verbs:
ask, love, do, write, put, shut.
These, while ordering or while commanding, are used. But when they are used in sentence, they come like this. I ask means I am saying what I do. In the same way, I love means I love. I am not saying others to love. Like this, when subject words are used with verbs, the meaning will be changed. Please understand this well. For past verb and also for past participle verb, meaning is same. You may get confusion here. See.
ಕೇಳಿದ ಪ್ರೀತಿಸಿದ ಮಾಡಿದ ಬರೆದ ಹಾಕಿದ ಮುಚ್ಚಿದ
ಯು ಮೇ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದೀಸ್ ವರ್ಬ್ಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬೈ ಜೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಡೂ ನೋ ದಟ್ಸ್ ರಾಂಗ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ರೊನೌನ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್
ಐ ಆಸ್ಕ್
ಮೀನ್ಸ್
ನಾನು ಕೇಳಿದೆ
ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯು ಲವ್ಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್
ನೀನು ಅಥವಾ ನೀನು ಪ್ರೀತಿಸಿದೆ
And we did means
ನಾವು ಮಾಡಿದೆವು
and also
they
wrote means
ಅವರು ಬರೆದರು
like these meanings are changed when the pronouns are used. Past participle verb can be used as adjective words. That is like this. After a past participle verb, if a noun comes, that can be changed into adjective. For example,
asked matter
means in the same way,
loud girl
means
Done work
means already finished work.
Written
letter means it is showing the condition of the letter. Like this, past participle verbs can be changed into adjective words. Now pause your TV and write them in your notebook. Present verbs or infinitive verbs can be used while ordering and also while requesting. While making sentences in present simple time, these can be used with pronouns. Then there we should not use any helping verbs. And also, they can be used in future simple time. There,
will
or
shall
helping verbs should be used with them. To present verb, when
ing
letters are added, we can call it ing verb, and also it has one more name, present participle verb. This ing verb or present participle verbs in active voice can be used in any continuous time. Continuous time means just it may be a continuous time or it may be a perfect continuous. There we can use. When we use these ing verbs regarding that continuous times, we must use helping verbs compulsorily. Past verbs, they are used only in past simple time and in only in active voice. While using these past verbs, no be form verb, no helping verb, no modal verbs are used. Using these verbs, sentence formation will be taught in part 3. Using past participle verbs, if you answer in short, only past verb is enough. But when we want to use it in sentence, helping verbs must be used compulsorily. Using past participle verbs, if we answer in short, single word is enough. But when we want to say in full sentences, helping verbs are required there. We must use helping verbs there. These past participle verbs are used in all perfect times.
Present perfect time, past perfect time,
and also in future perfect time. Past participle verbs are used in active voice and also in passive voice. In second part, in third part and in fourth part, they will be used. Whatever I have said till now, it is about only active voice. If you speak about passive voice, it may be any tense and it may be any time. There only past participle verbs are used. And also, while using past participle verbs regarding tense or time, we must use helping verbs compulsorily. This will be taught from 7th part onwards. If you get confusion in whatever I have said, you just do this much. Learn two kinds of verbs. And also learn mainly three forms of verbs. Usually, all say name, like name of things. Say always name of things in English, but mainly we don't know is kinds of verbs and forms of verbs. While making sentence, main part of the sentence is verb. That's why you must learn all the verbs and go on. To learn easily, regular verbs and irregular verbs are grouped in and given in 10 parts. Verbs belong to human, verbs used at home, verbs used at kitchen, verbs belong to birds, verbs belong to animals, verbs belong to motherhood. Like these, all are grouped. Necessarily, you must learn all those verbs. First, pronunciation of verbs and meanings of the verbs. Learn and go to next class. Taking your notebook, whatever the explanation I give and whatever I write on the board, write them in your notebook. Then it will be in your memory for a long time. In parts of speech, the fifth is
adverb.
Adverb means speciality of the work. Verb means action word. Add means add something to the action, that is adverb. In adverbs, there are three kinds. Some adverbs tell us about how an action was done or how an action will be done.
First one is adverb of manner of action. Here they say how an action was done. For example, is here S.V. Balasubramaniam sings melodiously. Sing is your verb. Melodiously is your adverb. Melodiously is saying about singing. Friends, usually most of the adverb of manner of action words are ended by ly letters.
Vehicles are moving slowly. The train is running fast.
some adverbs tell us where an action was done. For example, I am standing here. A bird has gone flying above my head. In these two sentences, here and above, two words are adverbs.
Second one is adverb of place of action. Here,
adverb tells us
where an action was done. For example, I met my friend on a road. Here, on is showing place of action.
Vehicles are passing under the bridge. The train is running over the bridge. The flights are flying in the sky.
Some adverbs tell time of the action. Time means not only clock time. To say about time, there are also some other words.
Third one is adverb of time of action. Here, adverbs tell us when the action was done. For example, I got up in the morning. Here, in the morning is telling time of action. Time means not only wall clock time. Other words are also there for adverb of time of action. For example, I got up in the morning. Got up is your action. The time is in the morning.
Many adverb words are given in this part and in the next part. Using book and using CD, learn pronunciation and meanings of the adverbs. These are required very much, so learn and go. Taking your notebook, whatever the explanation I give and whatever I write on the board, write them in your notebook. Then it will be in your memory for a long time. In parts of speech, the sixth is
preposition.
Means position showing words. Instead of your mother tongue, it is understood in English well. You know the meaning of position very well. Position means place of something. Some preposition words show the position of things or person. They say where the things are.
A chalk piece is in my hand. A statue is on my palm. Here, in and on. These are preposition words.
The computer is on the table. I am behind the chairs. I am in front of the chairs. I am between chairs. The keyboard is under a dictionary. The fan is above head. The dustbin is on the chair. The dustbin is below the chair. The red stool is behind a chair. The red stool is before the chair. The broom is at a corner. The chairs are around the stool. The red stool is amidst chairs.
Some preposition words show relationship between noun and verb.
I am going to airport. Here, going is your verb. And airport is your noun. To is your preposition word. To is showing relationship between noun and verb. Friends,
you have understood the meaning of position. What is the meaning of pre In English, pre means before or earlier. While making sentence in English, these preposition words come before the noun. That's why they are called preposition. Preposition words.
Airport is your noun. To is your preposition word. To is used before noun. That's why it is called preposition word.
Preposition words are not many in numbers. They are all given in book and also in CD. Using them, learn pronunciation and meanings of the words. And also, you may think as a homework or a project work. In your house, there are many things. Say in sentence where they are in your house. Say their position. Taking your notebook, whatever the explanation I give and whatever I write on the board, write them in your notebook. Then it will be in your memory for a long time. In parts of speech, the seventh is
conjunction.
Means connecting words or joining words. Instead of your mother tongue, it is understood in English well.
Connection.
You know that meaning well. Means joining two things. And also, you must have heard the word junction. In which department does it come? It comes in railway department. At the place of junction, different route tracks are connected. That place is called junction. The words which are used to connect two sentences or two words are called conjunctions.
You are watching this DVD. This is one sentence. And you want to learn English. This is another sentence. Friends, there are two sentences. To make single sentence, we have to use here one word, that is because. Now remove this full stop. Now it is only one sentence. Here,
because is
conjunction. Here, there are two words, you, I. We can use here and to join these two words. And is here conjunction word, connecting word. You and I are friends.
Conjunction words are not many in numbers. They are very few. They are given in book. Using the book or listening to the CD, learn pronunciation and meanings of the conjunction. Taking your notebook, whatever the explanation I give and whatever I write on the board, write them in your notebook. Then it will be in your memory for a long time. In parts of speech, the eighth is interjection. It may be a word or it may be a sentence which are used to express our sudden feelings are called interjections. Interjections. For example,
wow, hooray, oh God.
Like this. Words or sentences, they are interjections. Taking your notebook, whatever the explanation I give and whatever I write on the board, write them in your notebook. Then it will be in your memory for a long time.
A and the.
These three words are called articles. They can also be called by another name, that is determiners. We can understand it as sub words.
A,
an, and the. These three words cannot be used independently. These should be used only with other noun or name. That's why they can be called sub words. Before to learn how to use these articles, you should know about English alphabet. In English alphabets, there are only 26 letters. They are divided into two. The first is vowels. They are
A, E, I, O, U.
These are called in English vowels.
An
word belongs to these five letters. An means one. An article is used with a singular noun. Which noun starts with any one of these five vowel sound, there we have to use an. Sound should be observed by any one of these five letters. If the starting sound comes off vowel sound, there an word should be used. While using article an, not to observe beginning letters of the noun, but we have to observe starting sound of the singular noun. If the sound starts with one of these five vowel sound, an word should be used.
Umbrella.
This singular noun started with U letter, but when it is pronounced, A sound comes.
Umbrella.
A means A. A is vowel sound. That's why here an should be used. An umbrella means one umbrella. See one more word here. Engineer is there. It is started with E. While pronouncing, we say two types. We say engineer or engineer. It may be A or E. These two also vowels. That's why here article an should be used. Honest man is there. What should be used here? Here starting letter is H, but it is not pronounced. H is here silent. It is pronounced from here.
Honest man. Honest man.
A sound comes. A is here vowel. So an should be used.
An honest man. An umbrella means one umbrella. This word starts with E letter. Even though we have to observe the sound, it starts with A sound. Egg. A is here vowel. So we have to write here an before egg. An egg means one egg. This word starts with M letter, but don't say the letter. First observe the sound. Pronounce this first. M L A comes here. A is here vowel sound, so right here and M L A. Some more example, friends. Here S P. This word starts with S letter, but observe the sound. It starts with A. S P A. So A is here vowel sound, so right here and S P. And here Indian. I letter is there, but sound starts with E. Indian. E is here vowel sound, so right here and. Here R. Here H is silent, it is not pronounced. It is pronounced from O. So it comes here first sound R. A is here vowel sound, so right here and R means one R. Here ice cream. Letter is I and also sound starts with I only. So right here an ice cream. Here owl. It is started with O letter, but sound comes owl. A is here vowel sound, so right here an. And this word starts with X letter, but sound starts with A. X-ray. A comes, so right here an X-ray.
Taking your notebook, whatever the explanation I give and whatever I write on the board, write them in your notebook. Then it will be in your memory for a long time. And in English alphabet, the second kind is
consonants.
They are 21 letters.
B, C, D, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W X Y Z.
21 letters are consonants. Article A belongs to these consonants, sound. A, its meaning is one. While using this, a singular noun should start with consonant sound. A singular noun which starts with consonant sound, there only we have to use A. Let us see now.
A belongs to consonant sounds. This word starts with ma sound, ma, ma. M is here, consonant sound, so we have to write here A, a man. This word starts with T letter and also sound starts with T only, tree. T is here consonant, so we have to write here A tree. A tree means one tree. This word starts with B sound, boy. B is here consonant, so right here a boy means one boy. See this word. The word starts with O letter, but the sound starts with
Wa sound.
A 1 rupee coin means one rupee coin. A or an, these two articles are used with
countable noun.
Here, knowledge is not countable noun, but if there is an adjective before uncountable noun, we can use here A or an. Now, let us see the pronunciation first. G is here consonant sound, so right here a good knowledge.
Singular noun starts with vowel letter and sound comes consisting of consonant sound and vowel sound. There we must use article A. An example for that, there is a word
university.
Here starting letter is U, that is a vowel. But when it is pronounced, it comes like this.
U.
It is Y. It is consonant. It is O O R, vowel sound. These two sounds are in U letter. That's why here article A should be used. Some examples for that.
A unit. A eulogy. A union, a usurper, a united country, a EU, a European, a U-boat.
A means one, an means also one. This one means A or an. These are used only with countable noun, means which we can count. But uncountable noun means which we cannot count. For example,
knowledge, wisdom, water, sadness.
These are uncountable noun, means which we cannot count. If there is an adjective before uncountable noun, if an adjective word is there, considering the starting sound of the adjective word, A or and should be used there. Friends, there is a test for you.
Boys, girls, men, children, child.
With them, what will you use? There are three options. One is
A.
Another
an.
Another nothing. Think.
A or an means one. They are used with only singular noun. And also, if you know meanings of these words, you can use A or an or nothing. Boys means more than one, two, three, four, not single. So here we should use nothing. Girls means more than one, two girls or three or four girls, is plural form. Here also we have to use nothing. And if you know the meaning of men, men means more than one person, two, three, four, five, like it is also plural form. Here also use nothing. And children means it is also plural form, more than 1, 2, 3, 4 children. Here also use nothing. Child means only one baby. So here you have to use here a. If the noun is in plural form, we should not use a or an.
Now, pause your TV or computer. Say examples for a and an. Taking your notebook, whatever the explanation I give and whatever I write on the board, write them in your notebook. Then it will be in your memory for a long time. A and an, these are called indefinite articles. Indefinite means not definite. For example, a pen means one pen. Which pen? It means any pen. But article the is called definite article. The means particular or particular things or subject or some other. With them we have to use article the and speak. Once again I say, article the should be used with definite thing or particular thing. The first time if we are talking about a person, place, subject, some other thing, there one, a or an word should be used. Then it is not definite, means that is indefinite. If you talk about the same thing, same person or same matter, second time onwards, if we have already mentioned about that, then they will become definite. There we have to use article the. For example,
a man had come to house. Here we are talking about an indefinite person. That's why I have used here a man. If you want to talk about the same person, second time onwards, he will be definite person. There we have to use here the, because second time that person is now definite person. First time he was indefinite. So we have to use
a for indefinite person.
And again we are talking about the same person that we have already mentioned here. So he is now definite person. Use here the.
A and an, these are called indefinite articles. Indefinite means not definite. For example, a pen means one pen. Which pen? Any one pen. But article the is called definite article. The means particular, with particular things or particular matter or particular person or particular anything. With that, the should be used. I say again, article the should be used with definite thing. The first time when it is indefinite, a or an should be used. From second time, it will become definite. The should be used there. But to a person or place or something, while speaking, showing the hand towards them like this, their article the can be used from first. For example,
the helmet is in black color.
Here, I have said the helmet because I am holding it and it is definite to me. From the first time only, if you show your hands towards that and if you speak, you can use their article the. But for few things or for few matter, even if you don't show towards that, from the beginning itself, we can use article the. Do you know why? Because they are from the beginning itself definite. For example, with the name of seas and oceans, article the should be used from the beginning.
The Bay of Bengal. The Indian Ocean.
The Pacific Ocean. With the names of mountain ranges, article the should be used from the beginning itself.
The Western Ghats. The Himalayas. The Eastern Ghat.
With the names of public and famous buildings, article the should be used from the beginning itself. For example,
The Red Fort. The Vidhana Sauda. The White House.
In numbers, two kinds are there.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Like these numbers are called ordinal numbers. One more kind is?
1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th.
Like these numbers are called cardinal numbers. With cardinal numbers, we can use article the from the beginning itself. Example.
The first person, the second chair, the third period, the fourth exam.
Like this, with the names of famous posts or with the titled name from the beginning itself, article the should be used. For example,
the chief minister, the manager, the president.
If the names of places in plural form, their article the should be used. For example,
the Andamans, the Nicobars,
the Andamans, the Netherlands.
If the names of places have union or united in them, their article the should be used from the beginning itself. For example,
the United States of America, the United Kingdom,
the United Arab Emirates, the United Kingdom.
With the names of daily newspapers, article the should be used from the beginning itself.
Superlative degree.
It comes in degrees of comparison.
Positive form,
comparative form, superlative form. With this superlative form, article the should be used. For example,
the best, the smallest, the tallest.
Like this. About degrees of comparison, in the last means in the 10th part, it will be taught clearly and deeply, learn there. Article the is used with the names of invented things from the beginning itself. For example,
the wheel, the internal combustion engine.
Some more examples. Article the is used with names of ship. For example,
the Titanic, the Worcester Dam, the Ruby Princess.
Article the is used with family surnames or used with name of couple. For example,
the Mascarenas.
With the names of things or something, only one in its kind, with them, article the should be used. For example,
the sun, the moon,
the earth. Like the sun, nothing is there. Like the moon, nothing is there. Like the earth, nothing is there. Here we must use article the.
The earth, the moon, the sun.
Article the is used with words last and next.
The last patient, the next exam.
Like this, with these words the should be used. But with these words,
year, month, week
and 7 days of the week,
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
With these words, if last or next word comes there, their article the must not be used with them. If we use the here, is wrong. Just say
next year, last year, next month, last month, next week, last week, next Monday,
last Monday. Like this. One thing, an animal or a bird or a person. Like this. While talking generally, with that noun, article the should be used. The cow means, generally we are talking about cow. The computer means, generally we are talking about computer. There is no particular computer, or we are not showing about that. While talking generally, with that noun, the should be used. With the names of rivers and with the names of channels, article the is used. For example,
the Ganga, the Krishna, the Hemavati.
Friends, the can be used with singular noun or with plural form, with masculine gender or with feminine gender or with neuter gender. The can be used like this. There is no doubt. A or an can be used with common noun. Friends,
the.
This can be pronounced two types. One is
the.
Another is
the.
Wherever you use the, if the noun starts with one of these vowel sounds,
A, E, I, O, U.
Here, the should be pronounced the. For example, umbrella. It starts with a sound, a is your vowel, so here should be pronounced the umbrella. When you use the with noun, if that noun starts with consonant sound, there the should be pronounced the. For example, cow. This word starts with c sound. C is consonant, so THE should be pronounced the. Taking your notebook, whatever the explanation I give and whatever I write on the board, write them in your notebook. Then it will be in your memory for a long time.
BE.
B means stay. B form verb means word which gives meaning of being. That can be called by another name also, helping verb. And also one more name is there, auxiliary verb. They are
am
means being now. It is used with pronoun I. Are means you are, we are, they are, and things are. This is used with
you, we, they,
and used with plural noun or names. Is means he is,
ಸೇಂತ ನಿಮಗೆ ಇದುವರೆಗೆ ನೀವು ಕಲ್ತ್ರಿ ಆ ಕಲ್ತಂತ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನ ದಯಮಾಡಿ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿ. ಹಿಂದೆ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ಹಿಂದೆ ನಾನು ಸ್ಪೋಕನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ತರಗತಿನ 4 ತಿಂಗಳು ನಡೆಸ್ತೆ, 3 ತಿಂಗಳು ನಡೆಸ್ತೆ, 2 ತಿಂಗಳು ನಡೆಸ್ತೆ, 1.5 ತಿಂಗಳು ನಡೆಸ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲವೂ ಕೂಡ ವೇಗವಾಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ, ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಬಯಸಿದ, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಸಮಯದ ಮಹತ್ವ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅದನ್ನ ಕೇವಲ 12 ದಿವಸದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಮಾತಾಡೋದನ್ನ ಹೇಳಿಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ 10 ಗಂಟೆಯಿಂದ ಸಂಜೆ 5 ಗಂಟೆ ನೀವು ಲಭ್ಯ ಆದರೆ ಕೇವಲ 12 ದಿವಸದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡೋದನ್ನ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ನಿಮಗೆ ಅನುಮಾನ ಬೇಡ, 12 ದಿವಸ ಕಲಿಬೋದಾ, ಕಲಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಕ್ಷಿಯಾಗಿ ನನ್ನ ಚಾನಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲವು ನಾನು ಶಾಲೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿದಂಥ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಮತ್ತು ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ನ ಅನುಭವಗಳನ್ನ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಯಾರಿಗಾದರೂ ಲೈವ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ನ ನಡೆಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ತಗೊಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜಾಗಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ತೀನಿ. ಯಾವ್ದಾರ ಶಾಲೆಗಳಲ್ಲಾಗ್ಬೋದು, ಕಾಲೇಜ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಾಗ್ಬೋದು, ಸಂಘ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಗಳಲ್ಲಾಗ್ಬೋದು, ಅಥವಾ ವ್ಯಾಪಾರದ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲಾಗ್ಬೋದು, ಎಲ್ಲಿಗಾದರೂ ಸರಿ ಕೇವಲ 12 ದಿವಸ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡೋದನ್ನು ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಅದರ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ಗಳು ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ. ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ನಾನು ಕಲಿತಂಥದ್ದು ಕನ್ನಡ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ ಶಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ, ಆನಂತರ ನಾನು ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ನ ಕಲಿತಿದ್ದು ಬೇರೆಯವ್ರು ಕಲಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನಾನು ಕಲಿತಿದ್ದು. ಕಲಿಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೇನು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ಗಳು, ಓ ಈ ತನದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನೋ ಈ ತನದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನೋ ಅಂತ, ಈ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟನ್ನು ಕಲ್ತಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಸೊ ನನಗೆ ಅದು ಕಲಿಸೋ ರೀತಿ ಕೂಡ ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ. ಭಾಳ ಬೇಗ ಅರ್ಥ ಆದಾಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಈಗ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿದಂಥ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲದೆ ಇತ್ತೀಚಿನ ಮಾಡರ್ನ್ ಆಗಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ನ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಅದ್ರ ಥ್ರೂ ನಾನು ನಿಮಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಯಾರಿಗಾದರೂ ಲೈವ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮದೇ ಊರುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು 100 ಜನದಿಂದ 1,000 ಜನರಿಗೆ ಒಂದೇ ಸಲ 12 ಸಲ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷನ್ನ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ಬಲ್ಲೆ, ಸೊ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಟ್ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ಯಾರಿಗಾದರೂ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಶಾಲೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂಘ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ಕಲಿಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅಂತಿದ್ರೆ, ಯಾರಿಗಾದರೂ ಟೈಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ಭಾಳ ಬೇಗ ನಾವು ಕಲಿಬೇಕು ಅಂತ, ಸೊ ನನಗೆ ಕರೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜಾಗಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದು ನಾನು ಸ್ಪೋಕನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್.